Hi, does flying your drone around a park bring you joy? Well, I'm making this video today to tell you why that's fucking stupid. Hey, welcome to today's video, everybody. Today, I want to put my mouth, my money, where my mouth, I'm going to put my mouth. I'm going to test my theory that there are no good bind and fly freestyle drones. Now, let me explain myself. I see it going around that people think I hate bind and flies when you're kind of just misunderstanding my words. I fucking hate bind and flies. And I'm talking specifically about the marketing of 5-inch freestyle drones. That's not cool. I love my bind and fly micros. I love my bind and fly cinewhoops, long range quads, everything. I like bind and flies. I think they're super cool. They're super important to getting people into the hobby. It's a high, high skill level. There's a high bar of learning to get into this hobby. Soldering, computers, 3D printers, gaming PCs. There's a lot. There's a lot to get into this hobby. Anything to make it easier, I think is super cool. Well, not anything. Fuck DJI. I started flying drones in 2016, and it was true that most bind and flies, except for tiny whoops, fucking sucked. Everything sucked back then. Everything was underpowered and hard as shit to fly. But now things are getting better, and I see people starting off a lot on these 5-inch freestyle drones. And I'm like, this is a freestyle drone? Like, the frame doesn't really look like it. Like, these motors and the components don't really look that great. How are you marketing it as a freestyle drone? Because to me, freestyle, you know, when I think freestyle, I think, like, bando bashing, office parks, like, dive gaps and shit. Not really, like, park flying or park cruising, which is what these drones seem to be made for. Now, I'm not trying to fucking gatekeep freestyle. It is subjective. You know what I'm saying? Like, freestyle is freestyle. No matter what you want to do, you're expressing yourself with your drone. I'm just like, here, let me give you an example. Oh, hey, what's up, dude? I see you got a skateboard. You skate? Oh, yeah, man. A skate street. Oh, weird. I don't think I've ever seen you leave the skate park. You only skate in the skate park, right? Oh, yeah, yeah. But it's the same tricks. You know what I mean? So it's the same thing. You know what I mean? Like, it is freestyle. But when I think freestyle, I guess I think of, like, Tom Smith style, which is hardcore FPV. That bando bashing and shit. You know what I mean? Not, like, cruising in a park.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Not at all.
So therefore, like, it's few and far between to find an actual freestyle bind and fly drone. There's always going to be a weak point in a lot of them, and most of the times it's the frame. But shit, it's been a while since I've actually tried one of these bind and flies, and I could be fucking wrong. So hey, I got one. I hit Fox here up and I was like, Fox here, I see this brand new bind and fly Aurora freestyle drone coming out. Like, hey, can I give it a shot? So they sent me one. This shit's pretty tight, and I guess you can kind of tell, here's some foreshadowing. I should have recorded this B-roll before I went out and flew it, but this is a nice drone. There's little specs right here on what it's got, and it flies, as you will see, it flies fucking good. I like this drone. So hey, thanks Foxy for sending this to me. I really do appreciate it. There's a link below if you would like more information on this or if you want to check it out. So I went into this not being the biggest fan of 5-inch freestyle drones, and as I was trying to bind this, the receiver died. So that kind of sucked. So I was like, all right, whatever. I'll just put a new ELRS receiver in. It's just fine. And then the screws stripped out. So I had to get my fucking, whatever that thing is. I had to get my little tool. I had to get my little spinny tool, fucking spark it up and cut slots into it and then open it with a regular screwdriver. Like, I was like, oh, okay, fucking bind and flies, goddammit. So whatever, I got it all bound up, working the motor spin. Let's go out to the field. Let's go to Delaware, hang out with the homies and see if we can actually freestyle this supposed 5-inch bind and fly freestyle drone and how it does. Is that how words work? Fuck. All right, so here we are in the field. We're at some, goddamn, it all tangled. We're at some new spot in Delaware that looks kind of sick. There's like construction across the street. There's like some office park stuff and some buildings that you can't see behind me. So I'm gonna give this a shot. Like I was saying, bind and flies have traditionally always sucked. So I've been like, bro, these things fucking suck. But you know what, it's 2022. Maybe they make them worth a damn now. Let's find out. In true beginner fashion, cause I'm gonna fly this thing just like I'm new to FPV. I'm gonna use this walnut camera like I don't know any better. Yo, Caddix, like nice try, but the walnut fucking sucks as you're about to see. It's in 4.3, which they recommend. Caddix recommends recording in 4.3. So it doesn't overheat. I tried recording in different modes and it got up to 101 degrees, as you can see by this temperature gauge here. So here we go. First narrated rip with a bind and fly quad with a beginner's camera, beginner's drone, all this shit. Now this comes exactly as Foxier has it come, except I set my rates on it. That's it. So let's go. Here we go. Enough talking. Let's see. Can you freestyle a fucking bind and fly drone with a Caddix walnut on it?
Is it even flashing yet? Oh, come on. Just fucking do something, man. I'm pressing it. Nothing's happening. The camera's just fucking frozen. This, oh, nope. Wants to record. This thing is not recording. This camera is such a fucking piece of shit. All right, we're just running it.
Is it recording?
No, this fucking walnut's a piece of shit. All right, here we go. No Caddix walnut. Oh, okay. So actually, this is, can it do a roll? It can do a roll. Let's see how far we can go. So the VTX in this, I was fucking with the settings, turning the power up, and it went up to 2.5 watts. So this bind and fly looks like it includes the 2.5 watt Fox ear, which is why I'm inside. I'm only on 800 right now, but I'm inside the building. So that's cool. And I gotta say, actually, just these couple little flips. Didn't feel so bad. Let's see, let's go right here. Can it power loop? Can it power loop and roll? Oh, dude, this actually doesn't fly that bad for a bind and fly. This is what I was saying, like, bind and flies, juicy flick, inverted yaw. Nope, it is.
Oh, yo, wait. That's butter.
Huh. Get remote on. It doesn't want to yaw spin upside down. What the fuck? What? It won't yaw spin upside down. There it goes. It is doing it weird. Hey, these props ain't that bad either. Okay, so like right off the bat, I am fucking pretty dang surprised with how good this quad flies. Let's go see what's over here.
Why fly so good? Because it's fucking tuned and your quads aren't.
No, my quad flies fantastic. I'm surprised the bind and fly flies so well. I'm gonna miss that. Oh, the yaw feels a little wiggly, but that ain't fucking nothing. That's just some rate shit. Dude, Foxier, what the fuck? You made a bind and fly that I don't think is garbage. That is super rare. Oh, that's the thing. Let's see if I can even hit this hallway. Bro, this is kind of fucking crazy. There's some wiggle. There's definitely some wiggle when I, oh, is that a glass? Is that glass? Shit. I was gonna go full speed down this hallway. Yep, that's glass. Let's not do that. Bro, can it wall ride?
I'm not trying to break another window, dog.
That was a weak ass wall ride. We gotta try that again. This is doing okay. I'm gonna throw on a GoPro and do some rail ripping. I don't wanna have DVR for my entire fucking review. So here, let's give it a land, and then I'll throw a GoPro on this shit because this walnut's a fucking piece of shit that's never gonna work. Sorry, Caddix. Let's see if we can skid. Let's do a skid test real quick, and then we'll do the real one. Skid test. That was the, oh, it hit me. Okay, so that went really fucking well. I'm super surprised. I'm also very surprised because I'm using these Dal props that came with it. These props came with the drone. I love my HQs. Gem fans are really good. I just happen to not use them. But Dal props I've never really liked. These are actually fucking good. Dude, I'm so surprised. Anyway, let's fly some more and be more surprised. I put my GoPro on here. Big shout out to the homie Vampire for printing this mount last night so I could put the GoPro on it. I had a feeling that Caddix Walnut was gonna be a fucking turd sandwich, and look at that. Chomping away like a goddamn turd sandwich. All right, let's give this a rip properly now. I'm just gonna go for it. No babying this thing. I'm gonna fly this as if it were my quad and I don't give a fuck. Let's see what happens.
Do you give a fuck?
Izzy has an important question.
Do you give a fuck?
I do not give a fuck.
Okay.
Okay. All right, here we go. A real rip with the Foxy Aurora Dal props.
I'll put that D card in.
Let's do this shit. Oh, it takes off so fast. I wasn't prepared for that takeoff speed. It took off so fucking fast. There, let's see if we can power loop this thingy. I guess I should start from this angle. Oh, what? These are bad angles. Let's do this one. Oh, it's a little, so it definitely is lighter than mine, and I'm gonna have to keep that in mind.
How fast did it take off?
That took off fast as shit, homie. Okay, this is the worst power loop ever. Oh yeah, but I'm a beginner. I'm a beginner's quad, I'm a beginner. So I'm actually very proud of that. I almost hit the fuck out of that. Let's see a juicy flick.
Hey, beginner. Hook up the
juicy flick.
The
see, these inverted yaws are very weird. Did you see that? I guess maybe I'm not spinning it fast enough. All right, let's hit this thing.
Are you at a different camera angle?
I think this camera angle could be a lot higher than mine. Yeah, you're right. That is most likely why. This thing fucking kind of rips, bro. I'm able to pull out of everything I'm trying to pull up out of. Damn. So bind and flies are actually good. Or maybe it's just this bind and fly. I guess I'd have to try a few more to fucking figure it out.
Yeah, maybe you need to try a few more. Wink, wink.
How far can this go? How far do you think it can go? All right, we know how high it can go. Let's see how far this can go. So I'm running ELRS on it. Are those cars? No, that's nothing. Wow, it's going all the way to the building with sick video. Bro.
Dive the building.
Yeah, I'm going to. This
dive
is fucking kind of crazy.
Dive it.
This is kind of crazy as long as I don't. Oh, I fail-safed.
Oh, my God.
I fail-safed with my GoPro, so I'm coming right the fuck home. This is my GoPro. Oh, my God. So, okay. Wow, ELRS fail-safe. That's kind of wacky. What's up with that? What is up with that? Let's bring her home. Bring her home. All right. Let's do some shenanigans now that we got it back.
I can tell you why it fail-safed.
Why?
There's a big-ass fucking antenna array on the top of the building.
It's like fail-safing.
They used to be the cable building.
It was like fail-safing over here, too.
There's like 78 fucking...
It's flying all goofy.
...antennas on top of that shit.
Now it's flying good. Oh, did you see that weird yaw?
Yeah, what was that?
We got a fucking Chevy coming out here.
It's maybe just a tune or something. It's like... Oh. Oh. Is this in... What the fuck? Oh, my God. Is air mode not on or something? Look at this. Air, okay, throttle down. That's air mode not being on is what that is. That's so fucking dumb. So that wasn't a failsafe. I just can't keep. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So air mode is not on by default in Betaflight. Is that a thing?
No.
What the fuck? That's stupid. Air mode?
They should.
Why the fuck? Is this? I hope this hole's open. I'm just gonna go for it. Oh shit.
Oh. That was a fence.
Oh boy, what happened to my poor little drone? I hope these motors still work. Shit. Oh, one motor, two. Oh, dude, this might work again.
You all work for Chris Cunningham?
Uh-uh.
What are you guys doing on site?
Oh, we're flying these drones around. Just for fun, cool. Just because it's a little abandoned parking lot.
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah, I figure it wouldn't bother anybody. Just
nah, it doesn't bother me at all.
Hell yeah, okay, nah. Sick.
Bro, this is kind of fucking crazy. Even with air mode not working, this thing kind of fucking rips. I'm pretty fucking surprised. Like, a bind and fly in this day and age actually flies super fucking well. I want to put a... I think my camera died because it was full. I don't know fucking why air mode wouldn't be on. I didn't touch it or anything, but dog, this thing fucking rips. I threw some more of the dowel props on there. I'm not going to do a narrator rip. I'm just going to play some music, and I'm just going to give this a fucking hardcore flight. This is not fucking bad, Foxy. You're way to go.
Oh, so I fear I may have broken an arm, and it looks like, yeah, it's like a broken arm. All right, so this right here is the exact reason.
You got some dirty dangles, bud.
You like them dirty dangs?
You got some dirty dangles.
This is the exact reason why I say bind and fly drones aren't made for hardcore FPV freestyle. This is what happens when you take a bind and fly drone and you try to fly it in cement and concrete. A freestyle frame that's meant for hardcore freestyle will not do this. It might do this. But this is why I say you don't want to bind and fly for freestyle. We'll talk more about this later, but this is the exact reason.
Damn, man, I didn't even get to fucking try it.
Nope. I think I use like 150 volts at home. All right, that sucks that the arm broke on that, but before the sun goes down, I have my demibot frame here available on umagod.com. You should pick one up. These are meant for FPV freestyle. I'm going to tell you more about the Aurora and what I think. I do have a lot of positive thoughts on it. But before the sun goes down, I want to get in a good fucking rip. So here, me and the demi bot, we're gonna go freestyle this spot. Check this shit out. I broke it. It flew great. I don't know what was up with the fucking no air mode thing being on, but it flew really good. If you've never flown a drone before, I would recommend this, man. I'd be like, yeah, sure, buy this thing, but like, don't go fly it in a construction site. Go fly it over some grass or whatever. But it flew really well. It felt like it had plenty of power, man. That's pretty cool. So sure, bind and flies are good. You just need to like halt your expectations for what freestyle is if you're going to pick up a drone like this or the Nazgul. Really, any of the other bind and fly freestyle 5-inch drones, you're just buying a bunch of parts and a flimsy frame. I mean, if I can't say flimsy, like, it feels good. The frame feels good. It felt quality, had great flight characteristics, but as you saw, one crash into the concrete and it snapped an arm. So I saw a clip of a recent Bardwell live stream. Him and Blinty were talking about my frame, the BOTGRINDER Demibot. I just painted this one. I highly encourage you to paint your frames. I just painted this Demibot with this fucking super cool color scheme. You can get one today, demibotframe.com. But Blunty had said something about he doesn't see the point in paying more than like $12 for a frame or whatever. And if you do the type of flying they do, like if your entire career you're just going to fly your backyard, then no, you don't need to spend more than $12 on a frame. A bind and fly will do you perfectly fine. But if you want to do anything else than flying over grass, you're going to have to get out and you're going to have to get a decent fucking frame. Because once you get into the bandos, office parks, all that shit, you know what I mean? Once you get out of your backyard, shit gets rough real quick. Things fucking break. And freestyle frames like mine are specifically built to be able to fucking bash in the bandos, fly in office parks all day, take hits like that, and fly back to you so you don't have to fucking drive back home after an arm breaks, you know what I mean? There's definitely a place for these bind and flies for people starting out,
maybe people that can't solder, alcoholics, people that just have the shakes or whatever. And for people that just don't have time to fucking fly, sure, this is fantastic. But for those of you that are looking to get into FPV, hardcore freestyle, you're really gonna wanna build your own drone and get a frame that's specifically built to handle those types of crashes. In my description below, I have all the parts that I use, and I don't like to break shit. I don't like to fucking drive back home after I break a motor or a fucking arm or something. I have links in all my descriptions, some affiliate, some not, because I don't give a fuck, but these are all the parts that I use. This is the drone that I build that I find to be able to bash all day and not fucking break and have to go home and fix shit, you know what I mean? So again, I want to reiterate, Bind and Flies are perfectly fine. I kind of just don't like how they market them as freestyle drones, and freestyle is subjective, but like, if you're trying to do hardcore freestyle, you don't want to get a Bind and Fly. Your very first drone, sure, get a Bind and Fly, learn how to fly it, learn how to repair it, shit like that, but then you might want to swap those guts over to a frame that's meant to fly freestyle. Hardcore freestyle. I think Tom Smith coined it best. It's hardcore freestyle. Speaking of things that are hardcore, here's a list of people I want to share a hot tub with. Billy Hackett, Boris the German, Fred 805, J-Rod FPV, Juicy FPV, Lucas Roca, Maddie B FPV, Netcat FPV, Patrick Martin, sub new patron, Stompy FPV, Trent TT FPV, Twan Solo, Volleytronics, WOM FPV, and HempAndFriends.com. Those are my top tier patrons. Thank you very, very much to them. If you want me to say your name at the end of every video, you can become a top tier patron, and I'll say your name just like that. Patreon's like my main shit, so if you want to become one, I'll play your video on my Friday Night live stream. I'll send you stickers, I'll answer your messages, anything that you want, whatever you want to kiss on the forehead before you go to bed, hit me up, dog. I got a patron level for that. As always, thank you very, very much, everybody, for watching this stupid YouTube channel. If you enjoyed what you saw today, press the subscribe button or whatever. If you didn't like it, then fucking go cry. I don't know. Go be mad. I don't fucking care. I promise next time will be better. I got some good stuff coming up. Caddix, sorry I didn't like the walnut, but I didn't like it, and I ain't gonna lie about it. I'm not gonna make a video on it either, because I don't want to talk shit for 10 minutes, because I like Caddix. They're trying really hard, guys. Give them a break. They're trying really hard. The walnut just ain't that great. Did I say everything? I said everything. Listen to this stupid song. Did I say next time will be better? I can't remember if I did. I ate a sandwich I found on the ground. I haven't really been feeling right.